Manalangin po tayo. Dakilang Panginoon Diyos, may-ari ng sanlibutan, pinupuri namin ang iyong pangalan. Kami nagpapasalamat sa panalangin at gabay na ibinigay mo sa amin. Salamat sa panibagong araw na ipinagkaloob mo. Salamat din sa pagkakataon na ibinigay mo upang kami ay muling magtipon para sa panibagong kaalaman. Kami po ay humihiling na nawa po ay gabayan mo po kami sa aming pag-aaral at bigyan mo po kami ng makalangit na kaalaman at lakas upang kami ay matuto. At nawa po ang lahat ng aming matutunan ay magamit namin sa pagtulong sa aming kapwa. Patawarin mo po kami sa aming mga kasalanan at nawa po ang lahat ng aming gagawin ay maging alinsunod sa iyong kautusan. Ang lahat ng ito ay aming sinasamo sa ngalan ng aming Panginoong Hesus. Amen. Magandang umaga po sa lahat ng mga estudyante from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. Magandang umaga din po sa lahat ng mga professors, lecturers, instructors natin, pati na yung mga criminology graduates who will be taking the criminology's licensure examination. Sabihin ko na ngayon, congratulations in advance. I know you will make it. Prayer lang po. Yan po ang pinaka-importante dyan. Yung tiwala natin sa Diyos at tiwala po natin sa sarili. Yung mga estudyante pa lang, under the subject of forensic photography, pati na yung other students who are enrolled in other major subjects, ang Bitcoin po, nagbibigay po ng libre at comprehensive na discussion. If you need assistance po, you can refer to our videos. Mas maigi po na nagre-review tayo in advance para po may magamit tayo in time na mag-take tayo ng board examination. Now, I'd like to, number one, I'd like to appreciate yung nag-order po, or yung nag-order, nag-avail po ng libro po natin. Ang libro po natin is a compilation yan ng review material sa lahat ng subject. At the same time, andyan na din po, makikita natin sa last portion, yung question and answer portion para makapag-practice po tayo. So, sa lahat po na nag-avail, especially yung sa Mindanao and Luzon, ang very surprising nito, o kunti lang po ang nag-o-order coming from the Visayas region. Most of the people who ordered were coming from Mindanao and Luzon. So may appreciation po sa lahat po nag-avail. Nakatulong po kayo sa akin at the same time nakatulong din po kayo sa mga dialysis patients po na sinusuportahan po natin sa Negros Oriental. So maraming salamat po. Pangalawa po sa mga professors, mga instructors natin, sir, mga ma'am, andyan po ang PDF copy ng libro, PDF copy ng mga review materials. At the same time, pagkapos po tayo sa oras, andyan din po ang PowerPoint presentation. In exchange po sa very minimal price. In exchange of minimal price, I can give it to you. Just give me a personal chat. Personal message na lang ako through Facebook. Lagay ko po yung pangalan ko andyan po below the nasa description po ng video na ito. You can reach me, you can contact me via Messenger po. So, if in case kampos po kayo sa preparation, I can give you the necessary materials that you need. Okay? Now, without further ado, mga kadeti, sa previous unang episode po natin, nag-stop po tayo doon sa diaphragm control or yung lens opening. So, this episode, ang talakayin po natin is about shutter. Shutter speed, will also be dealing with the most sensitive material, yung film. At the same time, we will also touch about the different lens defects. Okay? Lens defects. Alright? So, without further ado, tingnan natin kung ano ba yung shutter. Review muna tayo, mga kadete. Ano ba yung shutter? Diba? Sa first episode, ang shutter po is a major part of the camera. Ang purpose po ng part na yan is to allow light to pass through. Okay? It allows light to pass through. It opens and it closes Yung pag-open niya, it allows light to pass through and it cuts off the light once it closes. Bakit kailangan ang light? Because the light is something that is used to strike the film para maging exposed tong film. Pag wala yung shutter, magiging overexposed. Magiging overexposed yung film. So there has to be something that will control the intensity of light that will expose the film. And that mechanism is yung shutter. Okay? Now, may mga different types of shutter po tayo. Okay? Different types. I think we have four. May apat po tayong types of shutter. Andyan na din po ha, mga cadets, ang picture para at least for reference. At the same time, we can have idea of what this type of shutter looks like. So, mga types of shutters po, depende po yan kung ano po yung itsura niya. Okay? Ano po yung appearance niya. Pag focal plane shutter, usually po, it's a pair of cloth or metal or plastic curtains which shield the film from the light. So, makikita nyo sa slide, yan po ang focal plane shutter. Pag leaf shutter naman, from the word leaf, okay? Leaf, it's like a leaf of a plant, okay? Parang dahon ng isang tanim. So, it contains a one or more pivoting metal leaves which normally does not allow light through the lens onto the film but which when triggered opens the shutter by moving the leaves to uncover the lens for the required time to make an exposure then shots. So basically, ang pinagkaiba po nito sa focal plane, ang focal plane is like something that will block light. It's somewhat like a cloth, metal, plastic curtains. Pero ito, ang forma kasi niya, ang itsura ng leaf shutter is parang dahon. That is why this is known as a leaf shutter. On the other hand, diaphragm shutter, kasi it looks like a diaphragm containing different number of thin, manipis na mga blades. Again, ang purpose is the same, to make light not to pass through the film and to probably allow it on a specified period of time. So, makikita nyo sa picture, tawag po niya diaphragm shutter. On the other hand, may tinatawag tayo, yung pinakalas, itong central shutter. Na usually, central siya because this is located within the lens assembly. Located siya directly within the lens assembly where a relatively small opening allows light to cover the entire image. Remember, that central shutter is also used for shutters behind or but near to the lens. Okay? The term is also used for shutters behind but near to the lens. Meaning, directly nasa ang positioning niya is directly within the lens assembly. Okay? So, kaya tinatawag siyang central. Alright? Now, these are the different shutter speeds. You can see 1, 2, or 1/2, 4, up to 1 over 2,000. Now, ang general rule of thumb po natin na dapat natin tandaan, mga kadeti, sa board examination, na the higher the number po, when I say the higher the number that I am referring would be the denominator, ha? Denominator. The higher the number, the faster the opening and closing of the shutter. Okay? I repeat. Yung pagmataas po yung numero, magiging faster po, magiging mabilis yung opening and closing of the shutter. Again, ano po ba ang purpose ng opening and closing of the shutter? Ang opening po, kasi ang shutter is a barrier, ang opening po, it allows light to strike the film. Remember na ang image will be recorded on the film. Pag too much light, ano mangyayari? Overexposed. Pag overexposed, may makikita ka ba during development? Wala. Ang makikita mo is purely light kasi overexposed yan. So, dapat intacto. Okay, intacto. Pag open yan, it allows light to pass and strike the film. Tapos, i-cut off niya when the shutter will close. Bakit i-cut off? Again, to prevent from overexposure. Balik tayo sa rule of thumb. The higher the number, The faster the opening and closing of the shutter. Bakit po ba? Ano bang principle nito? Napakasimple po. Pag 1 over 500, ang 1 po kasi dyan is second. Okay? Imagine 1 second divided by 500 times. That's how fast the shutter is. So if we will compare, pag nakalagay sa board examination, ano ang mas pinakamabilis? 1 over 500 or 1 over 2,000? Pag tatanungin sa board examination, 1 over 500 versus 1 over 2,000, saan doon ang mabilis na speed? So basically, ang mabilis dyan is yung 1 over 2,000. Because you divide 1 by 2,000, the result would be the speed as to how quick the shutter will open and close. Okay? As to the speed when the shutter will open or the shutter will close. So, basically, between 1 and 1 over 4, you would say that 1 over 4 is much faster as to its opening and closing compared to 1. Now, the question is when to use slow and fast shutter speed. Ganito po ang rule of thumb natin, mga kadete, ha? You listen up very carefully. Pag slow shutter speed po, gagamitin po siya una indoor photography. Ano ibig sabihin ng indoor photography? Pag ang crime scene po nasa loob ng building, gagamitan mo po ng slow shutter speed. Why? Kasi po, there's a big possibility na kulang po ang amount of light that will strike the film. Kasi pag nasa loob ng building yan, the area is not usually exposed to the sufficient intensity of light. Pangalawa, pag ang images that you are going to capture are still images, meaning they are not moved. These images are not moving. Okay, these objects are not moving. For example, let's say you are going to capture a cadaver, or you are going to capture a blood spots, or a finger Latin print. Basically, these are not moving. What you are going to use would be the slow shutter speed. Pero, pag gusto mo commercial photography, tapos you want to get an artistic creative effect to make the image artistically blurry, then you can use slow shutter speed. Pero ganito po, ang sa crime scene photography, we do not want as much as possible blurry images. Kasi hindi po ito commercial ha. Yung police photography, hindi po yan commercial. It's basically developing or producing an image that as much as possible accurate and hindi po siya blurry. Pero kung gusto mo commercial, you can use slow shutter speed to make it artistically blurry. But then again, we do not apply such principle po sa police photography. So basically, what I want to emphasize is you only use slow shutter speed if number one, indoor yung crime scene, pangalawa, yung image that you are going to capture is not moving. Next, pag fast shutter speed naman, saan mo yan gagamitin? Gagamitin mo yan if, again, you are going to capture moving subjects. Now, as applied to law enforcement, kailan mo gagamitin yung fast shutter speed? Let us say, for example, you are conducting a surveillance, tapos malayo, or probably you are going to capture the movement of a person running from one corner to the other. Basically, what you are going to use is fast shutter speed. So, yun po ang application po natin. Now, take a look at the image. Okay? Take a look at the image. Let us compare yung faster shutter speed at saka yung slower shutter speed. Now, if the shutter speed is 1 over 1,000, napakaklaro po. Ha? Napakaklaro po ng image. Now, as the shutter speed becomes slower, nagiging blurry po. Imagine the image that you are going to capture is a person running. Person running, ha? Let us say, nagsusurveillance ka. Part ng surveillance, nagtumakbo yung subject. Tumakbo yung subject. You want to capture him instantly. So, if you will use 1 over 1,000, you can capture. Probably you want to get the good picture of his face. But if you are using 1 over 4, shutter speed, tapos nagtatakbuhan o tumakbo yung tao and you want to capture him in an image, nako, ang makuha mo dyan is very blurry. So, pag faster shutter speed, okay, pag faster shutter speed po, more light needed. Pero pag slower shutter speed, less light needed. So, anong ibig sabihin ito? More light needed. So, ibig sabihin, faster shutter speed, gagamitin po yan pag ang taas po, mataas yung intensity of light that is available. Pag slow shutter speed naman, gagamitin mo yan pag less yung light na available. Kuha niyo po, mo po? Kuha ba mga kadete? Pag less yung light, anong gagamitin? Slow shutter speed. Pag ang taas ng intensity ng light, especially pag nakatirik yung araw, outside photography, tapos 12 noon time, it's a sunny day, talagang walang clouds, napakalakas ng intensity ng light, you can use faster shutter speed. Pero pag outdoor yan, tapos cloudy, then you can use slower shutter speed. Or probably indoor, tapos napakadim ng light, then you use slower shutter speed. Okay? For example po, tingnan nyo po ang image ha. Let us say, I think this is a paper fan. Rotating ha. Nagro-rotate siya ngayon. So pag slow shutter speed yung ginamit mo, napaka-blurry yung rotation niya na na-capture ng image. But if you use fast shutter speed, you can get the accuracy, the clear image. In the same manner, yung nasa baba po na picture po, 1 over 250 shutter speed, you can see na mas klaro po, hindi blurry. But if you use 15 second shutter speed, nako, napaka-blurry ng image. So yun po ang difference between slow shutter speed and fast shutter speed. Kailan gagamitin niyo yung slow? Pag still images. Number two, pag indoor. Pag indoor yung photography. Fast shutter speed, pag moving po yung object. Next, factors to be considered in using shutter speed control. Number one, the light sensitivity of the film which are determined through its ISO. What is ISO? ISO stands for International Standard Organization. Sa mga film po kasi, especially yung kababata ko po, who were able to experience the use of film camera, may ISO po kasi yung nakalagay dyan. Okay, that will actually tell you the sensitivity of the film to light. Okay, may mga film na mas sensitibo sa light compared to other films. Now, imagine this. Imagine, try to use your common sense. Pag napakataas ng ISO, very sensitive to light, at the same time, yung image that you want to capture is outdoor, midday, nakatirik yung araw, tapos it's not moving. Okay, it's not moving. Pag very sensitive yung film sa light, tapos ginamitan mo ng slow shutter speed, tapos nakatirik yung araw, nako, I tell you, more light will pass through, tapos napaka-sensitive ng film sa isang light, automatic overexpose po ang mangyayari. So again, ang shutter speed control will have to be dependent also by the sensitivity of the film. The sensitivity of the film to light. Next, number two, the lighting condition. Again, kung ano yung available light, whether it's sufficient or not. The motion of the subjects on different angles. Pag moving, ano ang gagamitin? Fast shutter speed. Pag still, ano ang gagamitin? Slow. Next, the purpose of the photographs to be taken. Pag ang purpose mo po is crime scene photography, huwag kang gumamit ng slow shutter speed because probably you are thinking you want to produce an artistic, blurry kind of image. Nako, questionable yan sa korte. Pero ang purpose mo natin is crime scene investigation. So basically, we do not use slow shutter speed pag moving po yung subject. Okay? So, let us say for example, makikita nyo sa slide, andyan po, you can use sa pag daylight po, ISO 100 to 200. Pag shade or indoors yung photography, ang gagamitin mo na film, dapat yung ISO niya is 200 to 400. Pag flash indoors naman, ISO 400 to 800. While darker indoors, mas maigi 800 to 1,600. Pag indoor at night, 1,600 to 3,200. Pag extra low light, ISO 3200 plus. So yun po ang gagamitin na film. Depende po yan sa ISO ha. So as you can observe, pag there is more sufficient light, mas lesser ISO ang gagamitin. But when the light is insufficient, mas bigger or higher number of ISO. Like for example, if you compare daylight and extra low light, sa daylight, kukunti yung ISO, 100 to 200 ang light sensitivity. Pero sa extra low light, talagang kulang na kulang yung light, especially night time, ang gagamitin mo is 3200 plus. Okay? So yun po. Alright? Next, you can see the three mechanisms, the ISO, the shutter, and the aperture. Okay? Makikita nyo yan, yung pinaka smallest na opening ng aperture, F32. Okay? Makikita nyo sa figure. You also have F1, 4, or F2. So, on the upper portion, makikita nyo kung blurry ba yung images. So, pag F32, napakaliit ng opening ng aperture, mas klaro po yung background. Okay? You want to capture the person, as discussed in episode 1, maklaro po yung background. Yung background po, as part of the clear images, clear image is basically part of the depth of field. Okay? Now, as the opening of the aperture becomes bigger, naging blurry po yung background. Okay? Sa shutter naman, ito ha, 1 over 1,000, you want to capture a moving person, mas klaro siya pag 1 over 1,000. Pero pag 1 over 2, napaka-blurry. Diba? May mga cellphones po tayo na ginamit, yung mga old cellphones po natin noon na may camera. Diba? Pag way back 2009 and 10, may mga camera na po ang mga cellphone. So pag pinipicture namin, let us say for example, the person will jump and will push the button, ang mangyayari, hindi po makuha sa image. Ang image po is never captured. Why? Because slow po yung shutter speed. Okay? Sa ISO naman, makikita nyo, low sensitivity, ISO 50, klaro po siya, ISO 100, so on and so forth. So, pag night time, gagamitan po ng higher ISO. On the other hand, mga kadete, for very long exposures po, may dalawa po tayong settings sa shutter. Huwag nyo po kalimutan na sa board examination, T and B. T stands for time, B stands for bulb. Pag bulb po, it will keep the shutter open as long as the shutter release is held. For time naman, it will keep the shutter open until the shutter release is pressed again. So makikita nyo po yan sa settings ng camera. Again, huwag kalimutan, B is for bulb, T is for time. Okay? Now, what you can see on the screen is basically a speed table. Okay? Speed table po. So, depende po kasi yan sa image that you are going to capture. But these are just examples. If it is a pedestrian, pag towards sa camera, di ba sa kanina, nagadepende po ang shutter speed sa direction ng isang image to be captured. So, pag pedestrian, pag towards the camera, ang gagamitin po natin na shutter is 1 over 30. Pag diagonal, 1 over 60. Pag across the frame, 1 over 125. Punta tayo sa racing car. Sa racing car, pag papunta sa camera, 1 over 500. Pero pag diagonal siya, 1 over 1,000. Pero pag across the frame, ang gagamitin mo po is 1 over 2,000. Okay? So basically, between the pedestrian and racing car, mas mabilis po yung racing car. So dapat mabilis din po yung opening and shutting of the shutter control. Okay? So yun po. Now, avoiding camera shake. Ito, lumabas ito sa August 2023 na board examination. Ang sa board examination kasi mga kadete sa forensic ballistics, there are a lot of cases na ang i-present po are only pictures. So napaka-easy, parang bonus question lang po. Kasi ang lumabas doon is yung image ng tripod. It's a three-legged device, di ba? Makikita nyo yan sa slide. Tripod po. Ang tanong doon, Identify the following image. Basically, it's a tripod. Pag isa lang, it's a monopod. Tri means tatlo, mono means isa. Pag isa lang ginagamit, for example, nagsi-selfie ka, monopod. Pag tatlo, tripod. Ano ang purpose ng tripod? To avoid camera shake. Okay? Unless you are using a tripod, the first thing you should ensure when choosing the shutter speed is that it is fast enough to avoid camera shake. However tightly you hold your camera, it will always move slightly as you fire. If you use too slow a shutter speed, this will mean blurred pictures. Pag medyo shaky siya. The speed you use depends on the focal length of lens you are doing. Okay? So how to hold your camera? Allow me to read. To be able to use the slowest possible handheld speeds, you must hold the camera correctly to avoid as much vibration as possible. That is why, nilagay ko po ang image between 1, 2, and 3, yung pangatlo po na babae, on the right side, yan po ang correct positioning po ng camera. Pag low-level shooting naman, you don't always want to take your pictures from normal eye level. So, kneeling position po, that will allow you to take shots at waist level. So, yun po ang technique po sa pag-capture, especially pag crime scene po siya. So, pag crime scene, dapat yun po ang kneeling position ang gagamitin natin, ha? Next, lens. Punta tayo sa lens. Ang lens is defined as the optical device with perfect or approximate axial symmetry which transmits and refracts light converging or diverging the beam. So for short, in a layman's point of view, ang lens po siya, isa lang po yung device that is cut in a axial symmetrical form. Ang purpose po niya is to refract or to converge or diverge the beam of light. The same manner po na ginagamit natin yung magnifying lens. So as you can observe, pag kinuha mo yung magnifying lens and you expose it under the rays of the sun, you can actually manipulate po, magre-refract yung mga lights. Diba, nung araw, we make it as a matter of play. Tapos susunugin natin yung tinilas natin by using the magnifying lens. So the more the light is converged, the more it is faster for the material to burn. So yun po, same principle po ng lens ng camera. Okay? Next, these are the types of lenses. Depende po ha sa surface. Okay? Depende po sa surface ng isang lens. From the word biconvex. Okay? Ano ba yung convex? Ibig sabihin ng convex, bulging po. Ah, bulging ang surface ng isang lens. So pag ang curvature niya is outward, pataas. Okay? At tawag po dyan is convex. Pag both of the sides are having an outward bulging, outward curvature, as what you can see on the figure, ang tawag po dyan, biconvex. Bakit bi? Kasi dalawa. Yung both side, first side and second side, are having an outward curvature or outward bulging. So, biconvex from the word bi. Pag concave naman, inward po yung curvature niya. Ah, depressed po yung curvature. So, pag biconcave, ibig sabihin ng bi dalawa, meaning both of the side are having an inward curvature. So, on the right side, yung pinaka-last, makikita nyo po ang itsura ng biconcave. Okay? Sa plano convex and plano concave, ganito din po. Yung una na side is having a flat surface. Yung other side is having a inward or outward curvature. Pag inward, ano ang type of lens? Pag inward curvature, concave. Pag outward yung curvature niya, it's convex. So pag ang other side niya is flat plus the other side is inward curvature. So ano na ngayon? Ang type of lens, it's plano convex. Ano na? Plano concave rather. Plano concave, ibig sabihin one side is flat, the other is depressed or inward curvature. Pero pag other side is flat, on the other side is outward curvature or yung bulging niya pataas, it's plano convex. Okay? So again, makikita nyo po ang example dyan ha. This one is a plano convex, the other one is a plano concave. On the other hand, positive or converging lens. This lens is always thicker at the center and thinner at the side. So, it's about the thickness. Pag masyadong thick po, medyo mataas po yung thickness at the center and thinner po yung sides niya, tawag po is positive or converging lens. Negative or diverging lens, on the other hand, thinner po yung center niya compared to the sides. So, yun po ang pagkakaiba sa dalawa. Positive, mas thicker ang nasa, nasa center. Pag negative, mas thicker ang nasa sides. Okay? Now, another topic, surely, cadets, that will come out in the board examination is on inherent lens defects or aberrations. Again, we have to familiarize po ha. Anim po ang lens defects. Una dyan, spherical aberration. Now, just imagine this ha. May lens po tayo. Let us just say plano convex or plano concave lens. The moment the light will pass through the lens, anong gagawin ng lens? I-converge yung light. Again, we tried it using a magnifying glass. Diba sa magnifying glass, pag gusto nating sunugin yung chinelas natin, we make sure that the light is converged sharply on a specific point para mas madali yung pagkasunog. Kasi pag watak-watak yung rays of light, mas matagalan po tayo. So ang purpose ng lens, as much as possible, hindi watak-watak. So nangyari sa spherical aberration, mas na-converge po the light passing through the near the central part of a converging lens, mas na-bend po more sharply yung nasa central part na mga light rays kaysa light rays that are coming from the edge. So meaning, mas na-bend more sharply yung light rays na dumaan po sa central portion. Ano ibig sabihin na central? Yung nasa center ng lens, mas na-bend siya more sharply compared to the rays of light na nanggaling po sa edges. Ang resulta, spherical aberration. Okay? On the other hand, may tinatawag din po tayong coma. Okay? Ano ba ang coma? From the word kamit. Bakit kamit? Because yung ano po dyan, yung image po na na-produce is somewhat like a kamit in shape. This is another form of spherical aberration but is concerned with the light rays entering the lens obliquely. The defect is noticeable only on the outer edges and not on the central part of the lens. If a lens is a coma, circular objects produced at the corners of the negative are comet-like form. So, ano ang sabi nito? Makikita siya on the edges. That is why, as you can see on the picture, mas klaro yung sa gitna kaysa yung sa gilid. Yung sa gilid dyan may mga blurry, may mga watak-watak na mga lights. Just like the spherical aberration, it is reduced by combination of lenses of different curvatures. Next, the third one is curvature of field. Ano bang nangyari dito sa lens na ito? Ang image po formed by a lens comes to a sharper focus in curved surface than a flat surface. So ibig sabihin, ang naporma po, ang naproduce po na imahe na nanggaling po sa lens, may sharper focus po sa mga curved surfaces compared to flat surfaces. So, what you can see on the screen is an example of curvature of field. Number four, yung tinatawag nating distortion. Okay? Distortion. Ano ba ang distortion? Dalawa pong klase yan. Barrel distortion. Pangalawa is yung pincushion distortion. Ano ba pagkikaiba dyan? Barrel distortion, pag yung ang picture will barrel out, will bulge outside. Okay? For example, you can see on the picture, barrel distortion po, pag outward po yung curvature niya or bulging niya. Pero pag ang bulging niya is inward, di ba yung face ng tao dyan, nagiging depressed, Ang tawag po dyan, pincushion distortion. Bakit magka-distortion? Kasi po ang lens is incapable of rendering straight lines correctly. Okay? So, hindi po niya makuha yung straight lines in a correct manner. Kaya po, ma-bend over or pwede pong magka-bulging outside yung image na nakuha. So, ang tawag po dyan, it could either be barrel distortion or the other one is pincushion distortion. The number five, the second to the last lens defect is yung chromatic aberration. Ang chromatic aberration naman is a defect which is the inability of the lens to bring photographic rays of different wavelengths to the same focus. So ano ang nangyari dito? Hindi po nakuha ng lens ang exact photographic wavelengths, yung different wavelengths po to the same focus, hindi po niya nakuha. So basically, ang resulta is chromatic aberration. The last is astigmatism. This defect is present when the size of image produced by photographic rays of one wavelength is iba po, is different from the size produced by another. Usually, sa colored photography po, ang resulta po dyan is rainbow color. Okay? So makikita nyo din po ang picture as an example of an image with astigmatism. Okay? So, types of lenses as to the degree of correction to lens aberration. Ito, lumabas ito in 2012 board examination. Pag chromatic aberration yung lens defect, ang gagamitin po natin na lens para makorrect yung chromatic aberration is achromatic. Okay? Napaka-easy pong i-remember natin yan. Pag i-correct po yung chromatic aberration, anong gagamitin? Achromatic. Pag distortion naman, ano ang gagamitin na lens para makorek, mawala yung distortion? Rapid rectilinear lens. Okay? Pag astigmatism, as well as other lens defect, pwedeng gamitan po natin ang anastigmatic lens. And apochromatic lens, on the other hand, corrected for astigmatism but with higher degree of correction to color. So, pwede din po siya sa astigmatism at the same time, yung higher degree of correction to color. Pero, ang pinaka-specific na lens na gagamitin in order to correct astigmatism is an astigmatic lens. Okay? I hope nakuha po natin, ha? Familiarize lang po natin, mga kadete. The next one is focal length. Okay? Dalawa pong terms that you have to study in this slide. Focal length, yung una, pangalawa itong tinatawag nating focal field. Okay? Pag focal length po, distansya po siya from the optical center of the lens to the film, to the surface of the film. Ang distansya niya po from the optical center ng lens patungo po sa surface ng film. Ang tawag po dyan, focal length. Ang focal length po, this is usually measured in terms of millimeters. Okay? Millimeters po ang ginagamit niya. On the other hand, ang distansya naman between the lens to the image to be captured is known as focal field. Okay, focal field po ang tawag. For example, makikita nyo po sa slide, ang i-capture po the image is at 3. Okay, at 3. So, the distance between the 3 to the lens is known as focal field. Ang nakalagay po dito, object at infinity focus. Ano ba sabihin ng infinity focus? We say infinity focus, yung distansya po from the lens, from the camera, to an object that will appear to be very clear. Klaro po. Clear po ang appearance niya po sa camera. So, ang tawag dyan, infinity focus. Okay? So, here is an example, an illustration of the focal length. So, 14 millimeters po. 20 millimeters at 24 millimeters po extreme wide angle lens. So, in comparison sa super telephoto lens, andyan po yung 400 to 600 millimeters. Pag normal naman, andyan yung 50 to 80 millimeters. Okay? So, iba-iba po ang focal length, depende po kung ano ang type of lens na ginagamit. Okay? Now, let us take a look on the difference between telephoto, wide angle, and zoom lens. Okay, ang zoom lens is the most the latest type of lens na ginagamit po, which is very dynamic. Una, ang telephoto lens, may pinakamataas siyang focal length. Okay? Ang telephoto lens, again, has the highest focal length. In comparison, ang wide-angle lens has the shortest focal length. Let me repeat. Ang telephoto po, may pinakamataas siyang focal length. Ang wide-angle lens naman has the shortest focal length. Kailan gagamitin ang telephoto lens? Gagamitin ang telephoto lens if the operation or the activity involves surveillance or tailing. Pag clandestine po yung operation, ang gagamitin po natin telephoto lens. Pero pag wide-angle lens po, gagamitin po yan especially po pag crime scene photography. Pero pag situation sa board examination, you are shadowing a certain drug suspect, ano ang gagamitin? Telephoto lens. Okay? Wide-angle lens pag nasa crime scene ka. Pinakamataas na focal length, telephoto. Pinakamababa, wide angle. Ano ba yung focal length? Distansya between the central portion of the lens towards the film. On the other hand, zoom lens, ito po yung, again, pinaka-latest, a very dynamic type of lens having variable focal length that we can adjust. We can adjust it whether it could be something that could have shorter or longer focal length. Zoom lens po. So, how focal length affects the image size? Lenses work on the principle that light affecting from a subject can be bent using the refractive properties of glass to form a miniature image of the subject. Lenses with short focal length, such as the wide-angle lens, produce a small image. Telephoto lenses with longer focal length produce a larger image when taken from the same distance. Klaro yan ha. Pag ang lens po may mababa na focal length, such as the wide-angle lens, mas maliit po yung image. Next, does focal length affect depth of field? So nalaman na po natin kadito ha, ano yung focal length. Ano ba yung focal length? Distansya po siya sa film at saka yung sa lens, yung central portion ng lens. So between telephoto and wide angle lens, ano ba yung mas pinakataas ng focal length? Ang sagot, telephoto lens. Pero pag depth of field ang pinag-usapan, ano ba yung depth of field? The distance between the closest and farthest objects in a photo that appears acceptably sharp. Ibig sabihin, if you want to capture an image of the person, pag blurry po yung background niya, ang klaro lang is yung person, pero yung background hindi na clear, ibig sabihin, mababa yung depth of field. Pero pagkuha, pag-capture, na-capture din very clearly yung background, ibig sabihin, mataas yung depth of field. So again, balikan natin ha. Pag focal length, ang pinag-usapan, mataas yung telephoto lens. Pero pag depth of field, it's the other way around. This time, mas mataas yung wide-angle lens compared to telephoto lens. Okay? Kuha nyo po. So pag depth of field, pag ang tanong sa board examination, saan ang mataas dito? Yung telephoto or wide-angle lens in terms of depth of field? Ang sagot, yung wide-angle lens. Pero pag focal length, mas mataas yung telephoto lens. Okay? The longer the focal length, the more restricted depth of field becomes. So, anong ibig sabihin dyan? Anong ibig sabihin dyan? The longer the focal length, pag mataas yung focal length, mas mababa yung depth of field. So, again, mataas ang focal length ng telephoto lens, kaya mababa ang kanyang depth of field. Hindi pwedeng pagsabayin yung dalawa. Okay? On the other hand, it's the opposite. Pag mataas yung depth of field, mas mababa yung focal length. For example, wide-angle lens, mataas nga yung depth of field dyan, pero mababa naman yung focal length. Okay? So, all things being equal, a wide-angle lens keeps more of the scene in focus than telephoto one. Kasi po, mas makukuha niya po yung background. So, again, in the picture of in the picture on the screen, yung unas, nasa taas, narrow. Mababa yung depth of field niya. Okay? Kaya yung focus point na gusto niyang kuhaan ng image yung, let us say, this is a fox or a dog, nakukuha is yung head, tsaka yung partial portion ng body. Kasi nga, mataas yung focal length niya, pero mababa yung depth of field. Below, yung focus niya is yung dog or yung fox. Tapos, yung distansya niya from the camera, nakukuha yung focus point. At the same time, nakukuha yung background. Kaya po, mas klaro yung background in the same manner, in the same clarity with the focus point. So, mas mataas yung depth of field na ginagamit. Okay? Sa crime scene, depth of field po ang gagamitin natin, ha? Yung wide angle lens po. Next, factors affecting depth of field. Una, aperture. The larger the aperture, the less depth of field. For maximum depth of field, use the smallest aperture. So, pag ang lens opening niya, is mataas, malaki yung opening, mababa yung depth of field. Pero pag ang opening ng aperture mababa, maliit, mas maganda yung depth of field. Next, pangalawang factor is yung focus distance. The closer the subject you focus on, the less depth of field. Of course, this is very understandable. Let us say, for example, pag you want to capture a blood stain, ang malapit sa blood stain, let us say, is a knife. Tapos you want to capture a blood stain. Tapos ang distansya ng camera at saka ng blood stain is just half foot. Just half foot away. Do you think makuha yung, ma-include yung, knife, yung kutsilyo, beside the blood stain? Of course not. Kasi nga po, distansya will matter. Depth of field is greater with distance subjects. Next, focal length. The longer the lens you use, the less of depth of field. This is what I mentioned a while ago. Wide-angle lenses give the greatest depth of field. Pero again, mababa po ang focal length ng wide-angle lens. Ang mataas niya po is yung depth of field. Mababa niya is focal length. Okay? So, yun po. Lastly, mga kaditi, I'd like to dwell on films and papers. Okay? I'd like to dwell on films and papers. Firstly, there are tatlo pong layers ng film. Okay? General layers of the film. Okay? Una, yung sa pinakamataas po is yung tinatawag nating emulsion. At the middle, makikita po natin ang gray or anti-halation backing. Sa pinakamababa po is a film base. Okay? So again, layers po tayo, ha? Layer. Yung nasa pinakamataas na layer, ano po ba ang tawag? Ang tawag po doon is yung emulsion. Okay? Nasa gitna, yung gray or anti-halation backing, yung sa pinakamababa is what we call as a film base. Okay? Kasi yung film po kasi natin is just a piece of material na pinagtumpi-tumpi po yung layers with different functions po yan. In emulsion, a suspension of a sensitive silver salt or mixture of silver halides in viscous medium as a gelatin solution forming a coating on photographic plates, film, or paper. Just familiarize the definition po, mga kadete. Now, the moment when the light will strike the film, ang unang matamaan dyan is yung emulsion. Tapos, yung rays of light will penetrate on the lower layers. So, ang gagawin ngayon ng anti-halation backing, i-absorb niya lahat yung rays of light in order to avoid reflecting the light outside the film. So, pag-absorb niya lahat, andun na po yung rays of light. Okay? So, ang may function dyan is yung anti-halation backing. Then, yung pinakalast na layer, yung lowest layer po, itong film base. Yung film base po, siya po ang nagsusuporta po sa emulsion that lies atop it. Okay? Historically, there have been three major types of film base in use. Just familiarize yourself. Cellulose nitrate, cellulose acetate, cellulose diacetate, cellulose acetate, blah, blah, blah. And then we have the polyethylene, triphthalate poster. I don't know if that is the correct pronunciation, but I'm not familiar with this type of chemicals. Okay? Now, to give you the bird's eye view, para at least maintindihan po, ganito po ang layer of the skin. Again, sa pinakamataas po is the emulsion. I'm just referring to the general layers, ha, yung tatlo. Emulsion yung sa pinakamataas. Then sa pinakagitna, andyan yung anti-halation backing. And then sa pinaka-lowest na lower portion is the film base. Next, we will go now to the characteristics of black and white films. O narito, yung emulsion speed. Pangalawa, spectral sensitivity. Pangatlo, granularity or the graininess. Sa emulsion speed, mga kadete, tatlo po ito. ASA, DIN, ISO. ASA stands for American Standards Association Rating. This is expressed in arithmetical value. Then we have DIN, the Dutch Industry Normen. Okay? Way back 2010, nagsisilabasan ang tatlo. But I do not know on the latest board examination. But just to equip you with the necessary information, yan po ang ibig sabihin dyan. DIN, Dutch Industry Normen, which is expressed in logarithmic value, and then yung ISO, which stands for International Standard Organization Rating. This is expressed in the combined arithmetical and logarithmic values. Okay? Now, next is spectral sensitivity. Again, familiarize po ha, mga kadete, as much as possible, memorize nyo na po ha. Pag blue sensitive film, sensitive po siya sa UV, ultraviolet rays, and blue color only. Pag orthochromatic film, sensitive po siya sa UV rays to blue and green color. But it is not sensitive to red color. Familiarize and memorize po. Next, panchromatic film, sensitive po siya sa UV radiation to blue, green, and red light or all colors. Pag infrared film, sensitive siya sa UV rays to blue, green, red light, and infrared rays. Lumabas din po ito sa 2010 Criminologist Licensure Examination. Who knows, paglaruan kayo sa board examination. So just memorize this, okay? Next, let us go now to the granularity or graininess of the film. When we say granularity, ibig sabihin dyan, yung size of the metallic silver grains that are formed after development of an exposed film. Again, I have to tell everybody, ang proseso po, ang produkto po ng development is yung tinatawag nating negative. Ang produkto ng printing is yung tinatawag nating photograph. So, ang metallic silver, ang size ng metallic silver, silver grains, na na-form po after development of an exposed film, ang tawag po dyan granularity or graininess. Generally, the size of metallic silver grains are dependent on the emulsion speed of the film and the type of developing solution that is used in processing. Later on, we'll be discussing about development process. Rules to remember, the lower the emulsion speed rating of the film, the finer is the grain. The higher the emulsion speed rating of the film, the bigger are the grains. The film developer will produce a finer grain that a paper developer will use for film processing. So again, we have to remember na pag mababa po yung emulsion speed rating ng isang film, mas maliit, mas finer po yung grain. Pero pag mataas po yung emulsion speed rating of the film, mas malaki po yung grano, yung size ng metallic silver grains. Okay? Let us go now to color films, mga kadete. Ang color film po is a multi-layer emulsion coated on the same support or base. May dalawa pong klase yan. Una, puro pareha lang po, color negative film at saka yung color reversal film. Ang color negative film forms a negative image when exposed, which is permanently fixed during development. Ang color reversal film naman, which is also known as slide film, gumagawa siya ng negative image when exposed, which is reversed, okay? Which is reversed to a positive image during developing. The film can then be projected into a screen. While in the color negative film po, yung negative po is exposed onto photographic paper to form a positive image. An example of color negative film is a Kodak color, while Kodachrome is an example of color reversal film. Okay? Next, photographic paper, black and white. Photographic paper is exposed to light in a controlled manner, either by placing a negative in contact with the paper directly to produce a contact print or by using an enlarger in order to create a latent image by exposing in some types of camera to produce photographic negative. Or pwede siya by placing objects upon it to produce photograms. Photographic papers are subsequently developed using the gelatin silver process to create a visible image. So, dalawa po ang klase ha, ang pag-produce po ng image sa photographic paper. Ano ba yung photographic paper? Yun pong doon po inilagay yung photograph po, yung image in a correct form. Okay? From the negative po, i-transfer po siya sa photographic paper pa doon po makikita mo kung ano yung image being captured. So, dalawa po ang klase. It could either be contact printing or by projecting. Pag contact printing po siya, it's by placing the negative in contact with the photographic paper. Pero in some other cases, pwede po by projection. Okay? Characteristics of a photographic paper, we have three. Chloride paper, which has a slow speed and is suited for contact printing. We have bromide paper na may fast speed and is recommended for projection printing or enlarging. And number three, chlorobromide paper, which is multi-speed and could be used in both contact printing and enlarging. So, tandaan nyo po ha, chloride paper, ginagamit siya sa contact printing. Bromide paper, ginagamit siya sa projection printing. Pero pwedeng magamit sa dalawa, it could either be contact or projection printing, chlorobromide po ang pwede nating gamitin. Okay? Next, exposure and development latitude. Latitude po, meaning dyan, the degree or amount of which you can deviate from the ideal exposure or development without appreciable loss of print quality. Degree of amount which you can manipulate. Next, ito naman po ang contrast range or grade sa photographic paper. Usually expressed po ito 0 to 5 mga kadete. 0 and 1, ginagamit po ito sa overexposed or low contrast negative. Pag 2, ginagamit ito sa normal exposed or normal contrast negative. Pag 3 to 5, ginagamit ito underexposed or high contrast negatives. Okay? So, which film to use? So, iba-iba po yung speed ha ng film. The faster the film, the more sensitive it is to light, the shorter the exposure needed. Fast film produces a grainier image. Film speed is measured on the ISO scale. Kanina po, I mentioned about this. So, pag mataas po yung ISO, mataas din po yung sensitivity ng film. Okay? So, between daytime and dark time, so pag daytime, mas mababa dapat yung ISO compared to night time. Lastly po, we will dwell on filter. Ano ba itong filter? This is usually mounted po sa holder accessory. Ang purpose po nito is to filter the light. Okay? The type of light that will be allowed to pass through. May mga types of filter po tayo. Una, light balance filter. Ang light balance filter, ginagamit po yan to change the color quality of the exposing light in order to secure proper color balance for artificial light films. Remember ha, we have to be very careful in using filter ha, kasi as much as possible, ang accuracy, ang integrity ng photography po natin should be preserved. So, di po tayo, we do not adhere on artistic way of photographing the crime scene. Okay? Number two, color compensating filter. Ginagamit ito to change the overall color balance of photographic result obtained with color films and to compensate for deficiencies in the quality of exposing energy. So for short, kinocompensate mo yung kulang sa isang imahe. Pero again, we do not adhere to this. Kung ano ang nakukuha po sa film, yan po dapat. Because again, we have to preserve the integrity of the photography. Number three, neutral density filter. This filter is used when the light is too bright to allow the use of desired F number or shutter speed with a particular film. Okay, ito pwede itong magagamit. Pero as much as possible, pag mataas po yung intensity of light, kindly manipulate only the shutter speed and the diaphragm control as well as probably choose the correct film or the correct ISO. Number four, polarizing filter. It is used to reduce or minimize reflections on subjects like water glass and highly polished surfaces. Okay? Lastly, itong tinatawag nating exposure. An exposure po, mga cadets, sa board examination. Dapat tandaan natin ha, exposure, combination yan ng aperture at saka ng shutter speed. Ang miscalculation po could result to either overexposure or number two, underexposure. For example, ang shutter speed mo is mataas. Let's say 1 over 1,000. Tapos, ang opening ng lens mo, medyo malaki. Ah, malaki yung lens opening. In that case, possibly po magka-overexposure. Okay? So, exposure again is defined as the product of the total light intensity and the length of time it strikes the emulsion. Ano yung emulsion? Yung sa film. Yung sa pinakamataas na layer ng film. Proper exposure is dependent on the film speed, yung lighting condition, at saka yung type of the subject that is going to be photographed. Okay? So, yun po. I'd like to stop, mga kadete, in this slide. And yung remaining topics po, ilagay po natin sa episode 3. There will only be 3 episodes in this subject. Maraming salamat po and thank you for advocating po sa pag-share po ng pre-recorded discussion natin para marami po ang matulungan po. God bless everyone and good luck po sa mag-take ng board examination.